Hello traders, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to show you how to analyze the market and predict the next candlestick. So let's start. This is AUD USD. The trend is downtrend here, and here the market is not good, but I will try. I think I'm going to take 5 trades here. So let me take the pair first. So I can see seller's entry, rejection from buyers, and it knows that the buyers say that, so the next candle will be bullish. I place call option here because I can see that this is a strong rejection from buyers. The trend is uptrend. There are some buyers here where the candle close, so the next candle will be bullish. That's why I place call option. Here the market is not good, but I will try. So let me see this. It knows as a bullish candle. Gave me a winning trade. Okay, here the market is not good. We can see green red pattern, so the next candle will be bullish and bearish. I place put option here because the market is not good, but I can see a green red green, then with the rejection, and the next candle will be bearish because I can see that the pattern is moving in the downward movement like this. So the next candle will be bearish. But the market is not good. It might close as a bullish candle some time. Here the trend is downtrend, minor trend is uptrend. The sellers are here. Yes, the sellers are there. It got rejection, so I'm very lucky that my entry is safe. It should have closed above my entry. Okay, here the sellers are here, so the next candle will be bearish, but I'm very late here. So let me take the challenge. I think it should close below my entry because this is strong sellers. I place put option here because this is a seller's area. Can see rejection from seller, so the next candle will bearish. So it should be bearish candle. Think close above my entry. This is a mistake I made. Here the market is getting bad, so let me place the trade again. So the next candle will be bullish. Okay, I place call option here because this is a weak seller's entry for this seller's area. Previous candle is very strong. The trend also is very strong. So the next candle will be bullish. Okay. So I lost this one because of my entry. The market is getting bad. This one also, because of my entry, I won the trade. So that's my luck. Here, I think I won this trade. The trend is uptrend here, minor trend is uptrend, and there's no reversal candlestick, so I'm going to place call option. I place call option here because the trend is uptrend, minor trend is uptrend, bullish movements. We we can see some weak sellers here. But I didn't see any reversal candlestick. So it means that the buyer will go more up again. Okay? So the buyers will continue. Trend is uptrend here. Minor trend is downtrend. A seller's movement. So I'm going to place put option. I place put option here because of this. This is next buyer's area. This is next buyer's area. Okay. So I place put option here because this is next buyer's area. The trend is downtrend. A strong bearish candle with a selling pressure and a bearish engulfing. So it means that the next candle will be bearish. That's why I placed put option. I think I've got this one too because of my entry. And after this trade, I will stop trading. I won this trade. Okay, so now I have taken 6 trades, 1 OTM because of my entry and 5 ITM. So I will stop trading. Okay, so let me explain. I place call option here because the trend is uptrend. The trend is uptrend. This is buyer's area because buyers entered strongly from this level. We can see some rejection, buyer's entry, rejection, buyer's entry, again rejection because there is a bias here on the left side. So it means that the next candle will be bullish. That's why I place put option. Yeah, I place put option here because the market is forming a pattern, green, red, green, red, green, and I see the rejection and I can see that the market is forming the pattern in a downward movement. So at this time, with this rejection from sellers, the next candle will be bearish because the major trend is downtrend. So because of my entry, I won this trade. So I place the trade in a safe entry. Here, I placed put option here, but I lost this trade because of my entry. Because the market is getting back. I lost this trade because the market closed above my entry. And why I placed put option is because this is seller's area. This is seller's area. At the seller's area, I can see rejection. And this is a reversal candlestick. So at this time, the next candle will be bearish. That's why I placed put option. But the market closed above my entry, so it's better to take trade whenever you see the market that you avoid it. Okay, I place call option here because of this weak seller's entry with after a strong movement and buyer's trend. Okay, and this one I place call option because still I can see uptrend and there's no sign of reversal here. No sign of reversal, but I can see uptrend, so it's better to follow the trend. That's why I place call option. And here, I place put option here because the next buyer's entry is here. You can see buyer's entry, and this is a strong candle, a downtrend, a bearish engulfing with selling pressure. So the next candle will be bearish. That's why I place put option. Okay, like this, you can place your trade with candlestick psychology when you analyze the market. Always observe the market when you are placing your trade and always know the market move, okay? If you like my video, like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.